What's going on, guys? Today I'm going to show you how to handle props in Vue. This is something you'll have to do in pretty much every application that you make with Vue. I have this parent component and a child component, which is an album. I'll pass props from the parent component into the album component and show the different ways that you can assign and handle properties. In the code, I've named the parent component parent, just for clarity. And then I'm importing an album component, registering the component here, and then using it here in the template. And then I'll pass props into this child album component, and then handle them in the child component. So right now they're just hard-coded. We'll go ahead and get rid of these, and we will be replacing these with the props that we're sending in. Save that, and there we go. So to first define a property, we can just type one right in here. We'll say artist equals a string Metallica. Save that. And then props. This can be an array. We'll just say artist is the prop that we're bringing in. And then in here, we can do these curly brackets, where we can display those props. So if I say artist, save that, and there we go. Another way you can do it is by doing it as an object. So we'll say artist and string. So the key of the object being the prop, and then the value of the property being what type of property that it is. Save that, still get it. But another thing you can do is, let's say album, we can do type is string, and we'll say default is no idea. Add a comma here so that quits barking at me. And now if we put album here, even though we're not passing in a prop called album, it says no idea. Now if we go in here and we put album equals master of puppets, we save that, we see master puppets instead of no idea. So if you pass in a wrong property here, it will not break the app, it'll just give you a warning in the console. So if we do, is that album number, we'll just call that album number. Let's say we do type string, and we put album number. These are always read as strings when it's just the word of the property and then a string. If you do V bind and then the name of the property, so we'll say album number, this will keep it as an expression. And so you can put variables in here. You could do expressions. If we save that, we get 11. And another shorthand, instead of vbind, you can just leave that colon there. And that'll also work. But to show you the warning here, so if that's a string now, and then we have it as, oh, so I said it, here, we'll change that to number. Now if you go in here, look at the console, get this view warn, invalid prop, type check failed. Expected a number with value of 3 and got a string with the value of 3. So sometimes you'll also either fetch data or want to work with some data in one component and then pass it in. So you can, Vue has these different options that you can use. There's a data option where you can get data or assign data. There's mounted, which fires off when the component is mounted. It's like lifecycle hook. There's a computed property, which is an option where you can kind of alter your data. But let's say we get a raw date back. We'll create that date with a new date, say 1986. Month is March. Months are zero indexed, so the 2 is a 3, and then March 3rd, so that's a 3 because days are not indexed. Dates in JavaScript are hard. So let's say we get this raw date, and we're passing that in. We're doing vbind here because we're not sending in just a string. That will be the key of this object. So we're passing it in as date, which actually, I guess for now, I'll just call this raw date as well, just so it's clear, because I will be changing it. So we'll say raw date. Type equals date, and then in here put the raw date and save that. Hit refresh. I don't know why it's not auto refreshing, but you see we get this giant piece of raw data that looks terrible and no one wants to read. So what we can do is use this computed option in our component. So we have this props here that we're using. We go down and say computed, which is an object. And you can assign these methods, which you can use as properties in your component. So we'll say formatted date. That's a function. And we will return the new date, and we'll pass in this, which will give us access. All our props in here will be available through the this keyword, everybody's favorite. And we'll say this raw date, and we'll say to locale string. We'll say the English US language option. and then another object as an option, where we'll say we want the month as long, so it spells it out. We'll say we want the day as numeric. And we'll say the year as numeric as well. And now you see that this is a function that we're calling, but we can actually just use it without the function call, just use it as a property value right in here. So if we change that to formatted date, and it's broke. What'd I do? Value numeric. Yeah, that makes no sense. Change that to numeric. Now if we look and refresh the page, there we go. That went smoothly. Okay, I also want to show you passing in booleans here. So if we go to the parent, if you just throw in the name of the property without assigning it, it'll be assumed it's true. So we'll just say good album, and that'll be assumed as true. And you can also do expressions inside this. So if we say good album, actually let's bring it into the component first. Good album type boolean. We'll say good album. If that's true, we'll say yes. If it's false, we'll say no. You can do expression right inside these brackets. Huh. All of a sudden it looks like I don't know how to write JavaScript. There we go. I have no idea why that happened. And then one other thing I want to show you is we have all these properties here, which is a fair amount. And our data object that we're returning here, we can say, let's say we have an object called album, and we have artist, Metallica, album, master of puppets, album number 3, raw date. Grab that. Say good album is true. We'll say false now just so it's different. Although it is a great album. So now you could do artist equals and then album dot artist, and you could do album equals album dot album, and you can throw in object properties like that. but if you want to throw in the entire object, you can do v bind equals album. And that'll throw in all of these as artist is Metallica, album is Master Puppets, and all of those, just like that. And now these are all still correct because we're bringing them in as, you know, as if we're saying artist is album.artist, album is album.album, and so this is all still accurate. And you see it says no there. Okay, so that's a lot of the basics for dealing with properties in Vue. Should be enough to get you up and running. If you like the video, make sure you hit that like and subscribe. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Check it.